Welcome to Learnpedia, the ultimate JEE and NEET prep tool currently being used by more than 20,000 aspirants. Now, take a look at this actual NEET question and see if you can answer it. If you think you got the answer, post it in the comment section below. To understand the concept behind this question, go ahead and watch this full video.
Nervous tissue. This nervous tissue is a part of the nervous system. Basically, the function of the nervous system would be to coordinate and integrate the functions of all the tissues and the organs that are present in an animal body. The nervous tissue is ectodermal in origin. The nervous tissue is basically made up of two kinds of cells. One would be the neurons, so these conduct impulse. The other kind of cells that makes up the nervous tissue are the neuroglia cells. These neuroglia cells, they do not conduct impulse, so there is no conduction. These are basically supporting cells. Let us first discuss neurons. Now neurons, they are the basic unit that would make up the nervous tissue. As they are involved in impulse conduction, they need to pass on these impulses. So these cells, they are sensitive to stimuli. Once they receive the stimuli, the impulses, they are initiated, then these impulses are conducted or transmitted as electrical signals. These electrical signals that the neurons would pass are referred to as the action potentials. So this is what exactly happens in a single neuron, and this kind of action potential would be passed on to another neuron, or it might be conducted through a muscle tissue or to any kind of glands. These neurons, they have lost their capacity to divide. That is, they have no regenerative capacity. Basically, the neurons, they include three parts. One is the cell body, the other one is the dendrites, and the last one is the axons. So let us discuss these parts of the neurons. So this is the neuron. So the first part that we are going to discuss is the cell body. So this is the cell body. This cell body is also known as the cyton or perikaryon. The structure is a cell body. It consists of the cytoplasm, and within the cytoplasm it has the nucleus and a lot of granules. Here you can see these are the granules. It has the nissl granules. These nissl granules, they actually represent the rough endoplasmic reticulum. As you know, rough endoplasmic reticulum are the sites for protein synthesis. They also have neurofibrils and lipofuscin granules. Now, a group of these cell bodies that are present in the central nervous system, they are referred to as nucleus, whereas in the PNS, it is referred to as the ganglion. Next part that we are going to discuss in a neuron is the dendrite. So, these are the dendrites. As you can see, these dendrites are tapering, that is, at the ends, they are pointed, and they show branching also. And these are very small cytoplasmic processes or extensions. These dendrites would contain the nissl granules and also the neurofibrils. The dendrite, they are the portion where you would receive an impulse. Dendrites are the receiving or the input portion of impulses in a neuron. And hence, they are also referred to as afferent processes. Afferent. The next part that we are going to discuss is the axons. A neuron would have a single axon. This is the axon. These axons are, as you can see, they're very thin in comparison to that of the dendrites. They're very long and cylindrical in shape. There is a single axon from the cell body, and the point at which these axons arise, this is the point, and this is the axon hillock. These axons would have the plasma membrane, and within the plasma membrane they would enclose the cytoplasm. So the plasma membrane here in the axons is referred to as the axolemma, whereas the cytoplasm is referred to as axoplasm. Here, within the axoplasm, you would have only the neurofibrils. You would not find the nissl granules. The axons might give rise to certain lateral processes, which are very small, very minute, and these are referred to as the collateral axons. Now, at this end of the axon, here you can see it divides into several fine branches, and at the end, you have swollen ends. This swollen end are called the synaptic knobs, and these branches, whatever you're seeing of the axon, they are the axon terminals because they are at the end of the axon. These axon terminals are also known as telodendria. In the synaptic knobs, you would have the secretory vesicles, and at this point only you will have the secretion of the neurotransmitters. The conduction of the nerve impulse would be from the dendrite to the cell body and then to the axon. So this is the direction from top to bottom. The dendrites are the input portion, that is, they receive the impulse, and This is the output portion, the axon. The end of the axons are the output portion to conduct an impulse. That is, they conduct impulses away from the cell body. Hence, they are referred to as efferent processes. Whereas the dendrite is afferent. That is, towards the cell body. Efferent means away from the cell body. Group of axons in a central nervous system is known as tracts. Whereas in the peripheral nervous system, they are referred to as the nodes. So this is the basic structure of the neuron. Now, since we have known what the structure of the neuron is, let us discuss the types of neurons. Types of neurons based on the types of processes. Three types of neurons. One is the unipolar one, other is the bipolar, and the last one is multipolar. As the name suggests, uni means single end. Bi means two ends. Multi means several ends. Actually, unipolar neurons, they may be true and the false one. Now, the true unipolar cells or the neurons, they are found in the invertebrates. That is, the cell body would produce a single cytoplasmic process. But in humans, the unipolar cells are present, but they are the pseudo-unipolar cells. So, this is a pseudo-unipolar cell, wherein the cell body would actually produce a single process, which would divide into two different processes. So, one end acts as the dendrite end, and the other end acts as the axon. This is the cell body. In the bipolar neuron, this is the cell body, and the cell body at one end would form the dendrite, other end it would produce the axon. So, two cytoplasmic processes, hence bipolar. And the conduction of impulse is from the dendrite to the cell body and to the axon. Bipolar neurons, they are found in the neurons in the retina of the eye, in the sensory cells of the internal ear, the olfactory sensory epithelium. Now, if you see the multipolar one, you would have one axon and more than one dendrite that arises from the cell body. And basically, most of the neurons that are present in the body is multipolar. Types of axons based on the presence or the absence of the myelin sheath. So, the axons are divided into two types. That is, based on the presence of the myelin sheath. If the myelin sheath is present, it is referred to as the myelinated axon. In the absence, it is called as non-myelinated axons. Let us first see the myelinated axons. Myelin is produced by two kinds of cells. That is, the oligodendrocyte in the central nervous system. Whereas, it is the Schwann cells in the peripheral nervous system. Both these cells, they produce myelin. This myelin, because of the presence of large amount of the lipids, they act as insulating material. These myelin sheath, they are wrapped around the axons. This is the axon and this is the myelin sheath that is wrapped around this axon as several layers. If you see, in the outermost layer, you would have the nucleus and the cytoplasm. This outermost layer, which contains this nucleus and cytoplasm, is the neurilemma. A single oligodendrocyte would be able to myelinate several axons. So, what is the advantage of the myelin sheath? Because the myelin sheath is present around the axon, the electrical signals that are being conducted or transmitted, they are being able to move at a very high speed in comparison to those axons which do not have the myelin sheath. Now, if you consider this as the axon and this is the myelin sheath. So, these portions wherever the myelin sheath is absent is referred to as the nodes of Ranvier. Actually, as the electrical signals are being transmitted, the presence of the myelin sheath, it would prevent the movement of the sodium and the potassium ions. But however, at nodes of Ranvier, they can move in and out of the axon. Because of presence of ion channels, there is exchange of ions during the action potential at this nodes of Ranvier.
Hey there, hope you understood the concept. Here's the solution to the question asked at the beginning. You can check now. Found this video useful? Hit the like and share icons to enjoy more such videos. Use the comment section below to post your feedback, questions or queries. LearnPedia's JEE and NEET prep tools contain more than 4,000 videos and over 20,000 questions. These can be accessed online on our website or offline through an SD card or a pen drive. To buy now, visit www.learnpedia.in. You can also experience a free demo of our product before buying.